There is Vasily. KAVERIN. His opponent is Hrant. TOROSYAN. Veronica Stooks of Hungary is the referee. This one, a battle between two 19-year-olds. This one, I was actually 19 yesterday. So, he'll be able to earn himself a belated birthday present in many respects and progress through to the round of 16. We've got 25 boxers making up the 81-kilogram light heavyweight bracket. So this effectively the round of 32 on the opening day of action in the 81-kilogram light heavyweight division for men.
Round one.
So we're underway then. Two southpaws facing off in this one. They hail from Russia and Armenia. The boxer in red is the Russian athlete, Vasily KAVERIN. 19 years of age, comes to the boxing ring as a two-time national championship silver medalist. And his opponent, his fellow southpaw wearing blue, is Hrant TOROSYAN, bronze medalist in recent national championships at the lower weight class of 75 kilograms. But of course, teenagers still growing. Who knows the weight class at which they will end up. But here in Kielce 2021, 81-kilogram light heavyweight boxers, and it's a measured start by both men. KAVERIN busy with his jab. TOROSYAN is taking the opportunity to limber up in front of his opponent. He was out of punching range, but he wasn't out of range of that southpaw left hand. He tried to counter, but he's spoken to about punching incorrectly with the inside of the glove. KAVERIN pecking and poking with the right jab. He dropped it down to the body, countered with the same shot from TOROSYAN. Nice use of the feet by TOROSYAN to put KAVERIN on the ropes and score to the body. Beautiful left right jab scored out of that southpaw stance by KAVERIN in red. Scored with a hard left cross to the body of the man in blue. Flicking double jab, the second one he fully extended and found a range. Lead right hook gets around the left glove of TOROSYAN. Plenty of patience being exhibited by these boxers, and there's a nice solid left cross out of that southpaw stance from KAVERIN. It was a right jab, and almost at the same time he uncoiled to land the left cross. And look at how he's backing TOROSYAN towards the ropes. Punches not legal, of course, in the sport of boxing. Two tall, rangy light heavyweights, and I'm just struck by the height of the waistband on TOROSYAN's shorts. It's practically up beneath his armpits. Anything below that, of course, will be deemed to be a foul blow. That strikes me as rather high. Beautiful left cross once again landed by KAVERIN, and he's timing that shot very well. And there's evidence, well, he's not really got much torso to aim at. Those trunks are so high. Or am I being harsh? But at least that's how I see things from my position on the ring apron here, or just beyond the ring apron. That would give him a very short torso and very long legs, if that indeed is where the man's waist is. KAVERIN has scored effectively with his left cross. He looked for the same shot once again, but was off the mark. The roundhouse left from TOROSYAN was off target as well. And one suspects that it will be KAVERIN who will be given that round. And indeed he is, across the board, unanimously 10-9. Vasily KAVERIN's punch picking, particularly with the southpaw left, earning him the nod.
Second out, please.
Давай, не сбавляй.
Round two.
Into the second round then. Vasily KAVERIN. Part of a full-size Russian boxing squad. 20 athletes here. 10 men, 10 women. TOROSYAN is part of a 9-strong male squad as KAVERIN lands with a good left cross once again and then spins off the line by pivoting. 9 men and 2 women make up the 11-strong contingent representing Armenia. TOROSYAN just a little bit inactive for my liking. He looks as though he's a natural counter-puncher. But he's waiting, and the counter's not forthcoming. And in the meantime, the busier KAVERIN is just piling up the points by single pot-shot successes like that. So TOROSYAN has got to try and get busy. But again, waiting, 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 and not looking to... Well, simply not getting his own shots away. And after conceding the opening round, 10-9, still time to turn things around, of course, but a minute has gone in the second. And now TOROSYAN starts to look for his own shots. Good right jab, but he takes one in reply. Hands down by his belt line now. That's inviting for KAVERIN, and he steps in and scores with a double right jab. The left cross wasn't too far away that he fired over the top. Nice right jab landed by TOROSYAN. It was a glancing left hand in return by KAVERIN. For that same backhand once again, the boxer in red, but nice layback employed by the Armenian boxer. Well, I don't think TOROSYAN's busy enough here. The way he's boxing, it's as though he's looking for a single shot knockout. While he's watching and waiting, it's always KAVERIN initiating, which is all well and good if you're a counterpuncher, but the whole essence, the whole art of counterpunching is TOROSYAN takes another left cross, is to punch either as your man is punching and preferably beating to the punch or make him miss and then score with your own counter. But the waiting is in evidence from TOROSYAN, but not nearly enough punching in order to be a counter-puncher. Right now, he's waiting and being beaten to the punch consistently. And if he carries on in this tenor with just 18 seconds remaining in a round, well, it's going to be another 10-9 round in favor of KAVERIN. And then really, TOROSYAN's gonna have to go for the stoppage in the third and final round. But I feel he's practically given this round away here. He'll have worked so hard to get here, and he's simply not let his hands go. Well, a rather subdued performance in that second round by TOROSYAN. And it's surely a clean sweep once again. And here's the evidence. He shapes up nicely, does TOROSYAN, but he simply didn't let his hands go. So some of the action, but it's practically all one way because there was only one man throwing punches in the second round. And it was Vasily KAVERIN. So what can they say over in that blue corner to rouse TOROSYAN? Because it's been a performance that has been devoid of zip and energy so far. Only he and his team will know why, and maybe his team don't even know why. Only he will know why he hasn't been able to get busy in terms of his movement, in terms of his punch picking.
Round three.
But he's going to have to do that here in the third. Otherwise, his appearance here at Kielce 2021 is going to be brief. Sporting touch of gloves to begin the third and final round. And Hrant TOROSYAN of Armenia has got to get busy. So is he able to raise the tempo? And if he is a natural counterpuncher, it's like trying to write with your opposite hand. If you've got to get on the front foot and be the aggressor, he's certainly not on the front foot. Is he going to increase his punch output? And with 30 seconds plus gone in a round, we're not seeing evidence of that yet. So the longer the sands of time continue to elapse and the clock ticks away, the more and more Tarossian is entering the realm of needing a one-shot stoppage or an RSC somehow to get the man out of there. But in order to produce a stoppage, you've got to let your hands go. Tarossian simply not doing that. KAVERIN winning this one at a canter, because the man in front of him, well, it's as though he's a sparring partner who's turned up just to move around. And again, these are youth boxers, remember, between 17 and 19 years of age. This is the biggest stage on which they have boxed. And these are all foundational stepping stones en route to the elite level, the senior level for boxers over 19. Good left hand landed by KAVERIN once again. Beautiful left and then a right uppercut brought into play by KAVERIN. Another left cross. Tarossian tries to retaliate with a left hook. But one wonders whether the magnitude of the occasion, as a left hook right hand lands by KAVERIN, but has the magnitude of the occasion perhaps got to Tarossian? Picked off effectively by a right left once again out of the southpaw stance from KAVERIN. Because again, I'm speculating here because I haven't had a conversation with either Tarossian or his coaching staff, but it just looks as though the occasion may well have inhibited his performance. Doesn't appear fatigued. He shaped up nicely in the first 30 seconds of the round. He was caught by some left crosses, but nothing that appeared to visibly shake him up. But he's remained in his shell for practically the entirety of this contest. And as such, KAVERIN is going to win this contest at a cakewalk. And that is not what you expect at the global level of AIBA Youth Championship Boxing. One suspects Tarossian is going to be incredibly disappointed when this final bell sounds. It is KAVERIN who will be going through, and he's barely broken sweat. Boxing at a slow tempo, one that he dictated, that he controlled, and Tarossian simply didn't let his hands go in this contest. Ice hockey great Wayne Gretzky had a saying, you miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. Well, to mix our sporting metaphors, if you don't let your hands go in a boxing ring, there is simply no way you can win, short of being the beneficiary of a disqualification. And KAVERIN not employing any means foul, so that was never going to be a possibility. And Hrant Tarossian, well, he's going to be eliminated from Kielce 2021.
The winner of this bout by unanimous decision is the boxer from the red corner, Vasily KAVERIN, Russia.
So it's Vasily KAVERIN who goes through to the round of 16 here in the men's 81-kilogram light heavyweight division. A unanimous point decision victory. And perhaps, I don't think he'll have an easier contest than that at international global level. Hrant Tarossian simply not letting his hands go, and the Armenian boxer eliminated in the first preliminary.